This is an original vintage poster from 1930 for the 101 Ranch Wild West Show. The poster was in frail and damaged condition with paper loss all around the edges. You will see what we did to preserve, conserve, and restore this poster today on Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Posterfix. Today, we've got a very beautiful and brilliant poster for 101 Ranch Wild West. This poster is printed in lithography. It had its borders chopped off at some time in its history, and we restored them after we limit backed it. Today you're going to see that, so take a look. Matt is mounting a piece of acid-free paper to the cotton canvas, which is stretched on a screen. The white borders have been chopped off.
Nice. I've got to take this knife off here.
This poster has a snipe added to it with Jack Hoxie's name. We'll hear more about why this snipe is on here later, but for now I have to remove it.
Actually, it says 101 Ranch.
I'm spraying the back of it with water as well, so it'll loosen the glue that holds the snipe in place. Okay, I've let it soak and I've taken off the snipe and I'm getting off the last bits of it now so that we can linen back it. We're going to lay it down directly onto the acid-free paper because I feel that the poster is too fragile to have the glue put on the poster directly and then flipped. So now Matt is applying the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper. Anyway, we're going to skip ahead because we didn't have time to mess with the camera while I'm training Matt to linen back. So we're going to let this poster dry for a few days. And when we get back to it, we're going to add the borders and do the color restoration and recreation. And you'll see all that in detail when we come back. Well, it's the next morning, and now we're going to put borders on these two posters. The 101 Ranch Wild West Show. Although this show was started in 1908 by the Miller brothers, whose huge ranch near Ponca City, Oklahoma, was known at the time for huge roundups and visits by President Theodore Roosevelt. This poster, printed by Riverside of Milwaukee, probably dates from about 1930. The Wild West Show had evolved through the 1920s as various members of the family passed on, but during the early years of the Great Depression, there was not as much interest in the Old West. In an effort to boost attendance, the 101 Ranch Wild West hired cowboy movie star Jack Moxie in 1930 as a headline attraction. However, even the addition of the motion picture star was not enough to save the show. And by the summer of 1931, the 101 Ranch was in serious financial trouble, eventually folding and filing for bankruptcy. This particular one-sheet poster was left on the shelves of the Riverside Printing Company when the 101 Ranch closed and returned to Oklahoma. Jack Hoxie would later start his own circus and Wild West, and when he learned that there were unused lithographs on the shelves at the Riverside Printing Company, he bought the remaining stock and had the title of his show painted over that of 101 Ranch. The Depression was hard on many other traveling shows, and Hoxie too closed his circus and Wild West in the late 1930s. Although there was some discussion that gangster Al Capone was interested in purchasing the 101 assets, it never happened. And although another show with the name 101 Ranch did briefly make an appearance in the 1940s, it was not associated with the original ranch show. And that writing is by our wonderful customer and patron and friend, Chris Berry, also a scholarly archivist of the circus poster. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Incidentally, if you have any questions about the restoration and linen backing of your vintage posters, you can get in touch with me at this email address on the screen or give me a call at that phone number. Tell me something about your posters. Tell me their size. Tell me their condition. And send me a few photos if you can. Whatever you can tell me is helpful. And I'll get back to you with recommendations for restoration and a price. Until then, I look forward to seeing your posters. We are now back in the Posterfix shop. We're doing the color touch-up, the finishing touches, using watercolor pencils and watercolor markers. We are almost done. It should be noted, the Miller's neighbor, Major Gordon W. Lilly, who performed as Pawnee Bill, motivated the Millers to produce a Wild West show of their own. The Millers made their transition from putting on local shows to the national scene in 1907 when they performed at the Jamestown Exposition in Virginia. Later in 1907, the Millers Brothers 101 Ranch Wild West show began the tour circuit in Brighton Beach, New York. Joe Miller, the eldest son, was an exceptional equestrian and star performer. Over the course of the show's history, its cast included Lillian Smith, Bill Pickett, Bessie Herberg, Beho Gray, Tom Mix, Jack Hoxie, Mexican Joe, Ross Hatton, and an elderly Buffalo Bill. A small portion of the ranch property was designated a National Historic Landmark in 1975. After Zach Miller's bankruptcy, the Federal Farm Security Administration divided the remaining ranch lands and sold off parcels to individuals. The 101 ranch house and most other buildings were torn down. The 101 ranch store remained standing until September of 1987 when it burned to the ground. Few of the 101 ranch buildings are left standing today. In 1990, the Oklahoma legislature designated State Highway 156 as the 101 Ranch Memorial Road. An historical marker is located on the highway about 13 miles southwest of Ponca City. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching us restore this poster for 101 Ranch Wild West. Like I said, if you have any questions about your posters, get in touch with me. Until then, I look forward to seeing your posters. And remember, at Posterfix, we bring your vintage posters back to life.